Hello, for you who is watching this video, I'm glad that you are watching it. First of all, remember to hit a subscribe and also set on the bell so that you will never miss any of my videos because I will be sharing interesting videos about how I can do different things in Blender using Blender. And now I have a very amazing, very wow version of Blender 2.90.1. Yeah, this is the latest one, I guess. Yeah, so now today we are going to learn how we can model an elevator, but we work on the part of opening the door, automatic opening of that door that we most of the time see in many skyscrapers. Yeah, and now we'll be using cubes. So you start from scratch with this cube, Shift A, and then you add the cube. Now see what you have. We have a cube here in our scene, and hits S. Yeah, we use the Y axis so that you can minimize the size. Yeah, to look it somehow like wall. Also SX to resize the horizontal size of this cube. GZ, you have to be specific when you hit GS and R, meaning rotate, resize, and move. Because when you don't specify whether it is X, Y, or Z, you are going to miss your parameters. So now we have a cube. I think this size is not that of realistic wall. Let's try to increase the height on the Z-axis. Yeah. So now we are going to create an opening for the door, the automatic door that we'll be using. And we achieve that by adding another mesh, cubic one, resize it on the Y-axis. Yeah, try to make it wider than this previous one we have worked on. Yeah, it will be better if you move it to fit to this wall. And now try to zoom to see whether they are matching. And now to create the opening of the door, we are going to use a modifier called Boolean. Boolean different, yeah, the difference. The object, it is the new mesh that you have added. So when you are using 2.9, remember to apply, because when you don't apply, you get nothing. So here you see when you move this, there remains an opening, which means that the part which was closing there is now moved to the new mesh in which you are going to transform into the automatic door. So we also need to resize this one so that it can have the size of door. Yeah, remember to specify the Y-axis. Yeah, I think this one is kinda realistic. So if you saw any kind of elevator made of a door system consists of one object or one part, this you can use just only one mesh or only two mesh. Yeah, but on the door, of course, we are going to use one mesh. Here you can record starting from here. Yeah. And here you can come on this side and move to the x-axis like this. And the record, you can see here that here it is recorded. Here I'm using the G key, the key G on the keyboard, and I'm specifying that it will only move on the x-axis. Let's try to see how our animation is going to look like. I see this one is so, it is very slow. You see that it is opening even though it is a door which is consisted of two parts. And now let's work on it. Control Z to remove the previous parameter, this previous settings, and remove this recording feature. And now we are going to add another mesh. But in order to make it look very realistic, you need to duplicate this one, and you need to hit Alt D. After hitting that key, you need also to move while specifying that it will be moving on the x-axis only, in order to avoid putting or having another part in the location which is not good. So can hide the first cube so that you can deal with this part of the door. But see that I know. Can move it a little bit somehow to the y-axis in order to look like the doors of an elevator that we most of the time see. It moves a little bit to the x-axis using G and X. Now it kinda looks like the door of elevator. So, but if you want, you can adjust it to the way in which you want. But me, I decided to use only those adjustment. And now we can make the other cube visible. This is the wall, not a cube. Even though here we use the cube, but starting from now, it's a wall. Yeah, you see that the first part of the our tutorial is finished. What's remaining is only just animation. Yeah, but there is kinda gap above GZ, and use GZ to adjust the height of this one. Yeah, so and then now can add keyframes. Starting from zero, can lock all the X, Y, Z, the rotation and whatever, and then come to, for example, 120 frames and move it to the X, G, X. But you see that here, maybe 3B is very fast. Let's take, for example, 130 and move it to the X, and then lock the X-axis. Yeah, because you see it is the one which has changed. Remember also to move this one so that, yeah, because they move at the same rate. And lock it. You can do in any orientation you want, starting from the last position to the first. And now you see, let's put it somewhere like here and lock. And now let's test our animation. You see that the door is open. Now you can enter. No problem, don't worry about it. You are allowed to enter this failure. But yeah, it is empty. There is no elevator inside there. In the next tutorial, it is the thing that we'll be working on. So the reason why you need to subscribe. Yeah. Now, if you want, you can add another mesh, shift A, call it pane, and just move it to the X view. Move it to the, yeah, resize it in all directions. Move it downward, choose it. Yeah, and now this one you can see it is very amazing. So now we see trying to add some colors, all right. So let's test the animation. See, it is opening even though it is very slow. But if you don't want it to be very slow like that, you can move the keyframes. And move the keyframe for the other door, the other part of the door. Yeah. And here you have your animation. And this looks so wow. And here, if you want, you can copy this keyframe and put it to somewhere like you have to do something that equal with equal interview intervals. Yeah, let's put it here and paste it here and go to the other part of the door and also copy paste. Now we can test the animation. It automatically close. And you see here, it is very amazing. So that's all for today's tutorial. If you want the next part of this video, please remember to subscribe because I'll be working on it. How you can add the texture, how you can prepare this plane to be changed or become a floor of a house, and also we add an elevator. I will show you how you can animate it to move upward and downward. So don't miss the next video. I will be there, and you will have fun with.